Hello, cheapskaters. My name's Kath Armstrong, and I'm the creator of the Cheapskates Club, where our goal is to live life debt-free, cashed up, and laughing. If this is your first time visiting our channel, welcome. And if it's not, welcome back. Today, I'm in the kitchen, as promised, with a cooking video. We have visitors staying this weekend, so I want to feed them. I want to feed them something nice. But I need to feed them something nice within our budget. So today, for dinner tonight, I'm making an impossible pie, an impossible cheeseburger pie. Hannah said it sounds disgusting, but it's actually really, really good. And if you're a fan of one pot meals, this is for you. Well, maybe two pots. This is for you. It's really, really good. Now you start off with some mince, 500 grams of mince, a chopped onion, a couple of cloves of garlic, and you cook that off. Now I've already browned the onion, so and the mince, and I didn't bother doing that on camera. Seriously, you guys have seen it. You know how to brown mince. You put it in the pan. I like to start with a hot pan so it starts cooking straight away. Let it get a crust, you brown it up. You know what to do. So I'm going to very carefully move you over just so you can have a look at what I've done. If you get seasick, close your eyes. I'll try and do this really, really carefully for you and slowly, because I'm not very good at this. You know, I'm still learning this stuff, guys. Is that too fast for you? And let's see how we go. Okay, turn it on just a wee bit. And I'll bring it over. And there we go. That's just the mince and onion and garlic, and I've browned it off. Now, because I'm feeding more than just my family, what I have done is I've added a cup of rehydrated TVP. So that's one cup of TVP with one cup of water. I let it rehydrate. Then I put that in with the mince to brown off. And this will give me double the recipe, because I'm doubling this recipe. Now you'll be able to find the recipe on our website, Cheapskates Club website, and I will put a link to it below. So there, that's done. This is the pie dish I'm using. It's a nice big deep pie dish, and it's a big one. Then I need to pop you back just a wincy bit so we can get to the other ingredients, because then we need to add some seasonings to our mince. So pan's cool. I'm going to add you can't see, maybe if I move this you'll be able to see if I pop it here. That's better. Okay, I'm going to add some yellow mustard, and I'm not measuring. It's not something I would normally do, but I'm just giving it a squirt. I'm going to add some good old regular tomato sauce. Again, I'm not measuring, I'm just giving a squirt, although I think in the recipe here it say 2 tablespoons or 3 tablespoons. Do it to taste. And because we really like it, I'm adding barbecue sauce. Again, I am not measuring, I'm just giving it a squirt. You can add salt and pepper. You could add other herbs if you wanted to. You could make it a Mexican cheeseburger impossible pie and add taco seasoning if you wanted to. Just stir that through. Okay, just to mix it in. Then all we need to do now is make the wet ingredients. The wet ingredients are really simple. It is eggs. Do I have a bowl to beat the eggs in? No. Let me get a bowl to beat the eggs in. Will that be big enough? Thinking, thinking.
No.
Let's go for a bigger bowl. It won't hurt. And I need a wee bowl. So, 6 eggs. And remember to always crack your eggs into a bowl first, just so they don't, if you happen to get one that's a bit dodgy. Get one that's a bit dodgy, you've not ruined the whole batch. 3. I'm using 6 eggs because I'm doubling the recipe. Okay. Now. 4. 5. I've got Lacey Dog lying on the floor behind me. Be careful if I step back. If I suddenly disappear and you hear a squeal, you know I've stepped back and stood on her. Whisk up the eggs. Break them up. Okay. Then we add Zonga Bazonga, milk. So, I am using powdered milk that I have made up because I'm keeping the fresh milk for our tea and coffee. You can use fresh milk. I'm trying to cut costs, and so I am using powdered milk. And I need 3 cups because I'm doubling the recipe. So, here we go. 1, 2, 3. And I will give that a stir too. And mix it through. Okay. Then we're going to add a cup and a half of self-raising flour. Now, some recipes will tell you to use. Get that out of the way. Some recipes will tell you to use baking mix. If you want to use a baking mix, we have the baking mix in the recipe file, and we've got the mixes recipe book that you can download, and it has the basic mix in it. And it is 1.5 cups of self-raising flour. 1.5. Now I've used my cup measure, so let's get the 3/4 cup measure, my handy dandy Tupperware measuring cups. And we'll go 1, 2, 1.5. Okay, now I have the oven on, set at 200 Celsius, preheating. We are baking. We are using self-raising flour. It has a rising agent in it, so the oven must be at temperature when you put your mix in. Let's just beat this up. Otherwise, your recipe, it will take longer to cook than it says. But also, let's get the lumps out of this. Maybe I'll get the electric meter out. But also, it won't rise as well if you've got something with a rising agent in it. So any baking that's got self-raising flour or baking powder or bicarb soda in it, any bread, any yeast products, they need to go into the oven ready to start cooking at the right temperature straight away, or they will not work properly. Okay, now this, no lumps. Making sure. Get rid of that. It's really important to do that. Now, all we've got to do is mix B with A and pour it into the pie dish. So, actually, I'm leading you astray. What I need to do is grease my pie dish. So, I've got my trusty spray and I'm just going to Normally I would just boil it. Then we are going to, spread the meat in the bottom of the pie dish. So, can you see what I'm doing? Let me see if you can see what I'm doing. That'd help, wouldn't it? Yep, you can see what I'm doing. Spread the meat mixture in the bottom of the pie dish. And maybe, I might have enough for two. Bigger pie dish. Okay, we will make two. Let me get another pie dish. Here we go. And that was easy. We'll make two. Two smaller ones. In it goes. Doesn't matter whether you make one or two, as long as I've got enough for everybody for dinner tonight, we're all back sitting pretty. And I did wash my hands before we started. Don't start having hysterics because I haven't washed my hands. Okay, spread it like so. All right, see, it's real cooking with me, you know. I'm never gonna be. So we've got this one spread, we've got this one spread. Then we'll just give the, sorry Lacey, I did, I stepped back on Lacey dog. Oh, give that, put half into there, half into there, a bit more in there, a bit more in there, a bit more in there. Beautiful. Swish it around so that it's all covered, because we want it all covered. Now, these go into the oven. The oven is, as I said, preheated at 200 degrees, and we put them in the oven and we let them bake for 25 minutes. So just watch while I turn you around so you can see what I'm doing. It's a bit shaky, sorry guys. And let's get them into the oven. Set the timer for 25 minutes. They'll cook and I'll be back when the timer goes ding. I'll be back when the timer goes ding. Hannah said, what about the cheese? Wait and see. Okay, see you in 25 minutes. Cheeseburger pies are out of the oven. Let me flip you down so you can see them. I'll just carefully, sorry guys, move you a bit. There you go. Not quite finished. Next step, cheese on top. So, because it's a cheeseburger impossible pie, so it's got to have cheese in it somewhere, doesn't it? Now, it's supposed to have, Hannah's giggling in the background.
At Lacey.
Oh, she says she's giggling at Lacey, but I don't know. I reckon she's mocking her mother. The recipe says to put sliced tomato under the cheese. I don't have any tomatoes, so I'm not doing that. We will just pour cheese over the top. Then it goes back into the oven for 10 minutes. So we'll try again. Back into the oven. My ears are popping this morning. Okay. Back into the oven for 10 minutes until it's golden brown. The cheese is golden brown. And then it's ready. So I'll let them cool, pop them in the fridge, and we'll have those tonight for tea. And I'm going to have salad with them, I've decided. Now, I doubled the recipe by adding TVP instead of more mince to keep the costs down. I used powdered milk made up instead of fresh milk to keep the cost down. I decided what seasonings I wanted, so I added mustard, tomato sauce, and barbecue sauce. If you didn't want to do that, you could add a packet of French onion soup or a packet of cream of mushroom soup, the dry packets, and use those for seasonings. Tomato paste, whatever you've got, it's quite versatile when you think about it. No waste. Now, the other thing that you could do is make it gluten-free by using gluten-free flour. Easy. Low-fat milk is fine. What else did I have to tell you? Let me get the recipe and make sure, because I had notes somewhere of what I was going to talk about. It's really nice, hot or cold. There you go. So if you want to bake it, take for a picnic, you can. If you want to make it and cut it in wedges and pack it in lunch boxes, you can. It's easy and it's versatile and it's really quite quick to put together. Once it's in the oven, put the timer on, don't forget the timer, and then you can go off and do other things while it was cooking for that 25 minutes. I put everything away, washed up the dishes, wiped down the benches, had a chat to Hannah for a few minutes. So I didn't waste 25 minutes, and it wasn't constant cooking time, hands-on cooking time either. Yes, it freezes. You can freeze it and reheat it. It's better reheated in the oven than it is in the microwave, but most things are better reheated in the oven than they are in the microwave. It's reasonably inexpensive. I didn't have a fresh onion, so I rehydrated some dehydrated onion. That works well. I didn't have fresh garlic, so I just used dried garlic. Use what you have and make it your own. Now I'm just sitting here. Let me see. 500 grams of mince is $4.50.
No.
One and a half cups of milk is, say, 40 cents. So that's $4.90. 3/4 of a cup of flour is 25 cents. So that's $5.15. Am I right? Three eggs. Eggs are 30 cents each. $5.15 and $1.90 is $6.15 less 10, $6.05. Then your grated cheese. Now, you can, I didn't do it this time, but you can stretch your grated cheese by using half grated cheese and half biscuit crumbs, Weet-Bix crumbs, even bread crumbs to stretch it. Mix it with the cheese and then put it on as a topping. You can do that. That will bring your cost down. Cup of grated cheese is about $1. So what are we up to? $7.05, thereabouts. And say 50 cents for the mustard tomato sauce. So $7.55. It will serve, should get 8 serves out of one pie. So that's under $1 a serve, which is not too bad. And they're big serves because that is my big pie dish. They're my two biggest pie dishes. They are big serves. Of course, if you have your own chickens, the cost comes down. If you get mince on markdown, the cost comes down. There's a lot of ways you can make this meal actually cheaper so that it doesn't cost as much for you. It is budget friendly and it is quite easy to do. And I love impossible pies. So, in the comments, tell me if you like impossible pies, if you've never tried them. The first one I ever tried was, I think, the original impossible pie recipe, and it was before we were married. And it was my great auntie Jean that taught it to me. And it was the one with coconut and lemon. And it was just delicious. Absolutely beautiful pie. It's so nice to make. And you don't think it's going to work, but you've got the little bit of crust, the custard, the coconut on the top. It's really nice. There's a lot of variations now. In the Cheapskates Club recipe file, there's a Mexican one. There's a lemon impossible pie. That's really good. Really, really good, the lemon impossible pie. And again, you think it's not going to work, and it does. It just does. There's a lot of variations on them. And as I said with this recipe, leave out the tomato sauce and the barbecue sauce and the mustard and use taco seasoning and give it a Mexican flavor. Or add some Italian herbs and a little tomato sauce and give it an Italian flavor. There's a lot of things you can do with it. Use your imagination because you know what you like. You know what your family will eat. So cook to your likes. Swap things out. Make them your own. Create a new recipe. Now I'm waiting for this to go ding. Oh, the cheese is melting. It looks really good. As soon as it goes ding, I'll come back and we'll have a look at it. I'll see you in a few minutes. Okay, we're back. Let me show you. I've taken them out just a couple of minutes early. They're not quite as brown as they want to be because I will reheat it this afternoon for dinner. So let me just show you. They look really good. Look. Now, put a knife in. Looks good to me. What a knife in. Looks good to me. They look cooked to me. So this is impossible cheeseburger pie. Pull it out of the oven. It's starting to come away from the edges, so it's nicely done, which is good in how you test your cakes. If they're coming away from the edges, they're done. Let it sit. If you're going to serve it straight away, let it sit in the dish for 5 minutes or so to settle before you cut it, and then serve it and enjoy it. That's today's cooking. How easy is that? And it smells really good too. Actually smells really, really good. So, my lovelies, let me just get back where I've got to be. There we go. Tick me up a bit so you can see me. Is that better? Yes. There you go. Impossible cheeseburger pie. It's inexpensive. It's really easy. It's quick. It's tasty. It freezes. It can be made gluten-free. You could use chicken mince instead of beef mince. You could use pork mince instead of beef mince if you wanted to. There's a lot of options with this recipe, and you will find it. I'll put the link below me. You will find it in our Cheapskates Club recipe file. Okay, if you've made it this far, thank you for watching. I'd love for you to let me know that you made it this far by putting cheeseburger in the comments. That way I know how many people actually watch our videos right to the end, whether I'm making them too long, too short, whatever. It really helps me if you do that. The other thing I'd really appreciate is a thumbs up. That really helps us too. And if you're not subscribed to our channel, click the subscribe button, then click the little bell, and we will notify you every time we upload a new video. Thank you so much for joining me. Happy cheapskating. I'll see you next time. Maybe I'll see you next time. I can't turn off. I don't know where I am. I've lost my thing. Okay, we'll try again. I'll see you next time.